Welcome back, Pokemon trainers. Professor Chaz here. The lab coat's on back order, and it's time for this week's Pokemon Omega Ruby rotation battles in the free battle in Battle Spot. Now, as I mentioned in yesterday's team building video, which I have a link to down in the description, if you want to click that, you'll check out the ideas for strategies and movesets and held items and all that good stuff. The two Pokemon that have not yet been used in the rotation battles for our final week, which is what this week is Snapper the Totodile and Burrow the Ninjask. So we're giving them one last shot for these rotation battles because they haven't yet been used. We want to see if we can get some wins for these guys. Hopefully we can, and it'll round out the rotation battles at only one loss in Cliff the Clefairy. But, you know, you never know what's going to happen. Hopefully the team I've assembled will get these two Pokemon into the winning circle, but we're never going to know until we get into these battles right now. So let's check out the first of the battles in this week's Pokemon Omega Ruby rotation battles. Our opponent for the final week of the rotation battles is character unnamed, or non-pronounced, from South Korea. We see all level 50s, three held items. Going to see some Mega Evolution or Primal Reversion based on what Pokemon are holding those items. Now we see a Charizard, Rayquaza, Kyogre, Mewtwo, Lugia, and Cobalion. So even though the Rayquaza doesn't have a held item, of course it doesn't need a Mega Stone to Mega Evolve, so Mega Rayquaza could be a thing in this battle. So who do I want to go ahead and bring? I think type effective-wise, the two Pokemon that haven't been used yet, Snapper is the best, so we're going to lead with him. And his biggest threats on the opposing side doesn't really have anything type effective-wise that he's going to be weak against. So let's take a look at what we can do damage-wise. Now, I want to think defensively, of course. Something I did learn from the Johto Classic. I want to go ahead and bring our Clefable to set up the Reflect. Don't foresee a lot of physical offense on the opposing side. Cobalion, probably. Probably the Rayquaza. Maybe if it's a Mega Mewtwo X as well. So we can get the Reflect, we can get some physical defense. And I might want to bring Witwicky. His Flash Fire could absorb an attack from the Charizard. And we could burn everything except the Charizard with the Will-O-Wisp. Plus, if I bring him in one of the rear spots, they're not going to see he has Air Balloon. Now, I don't think it's going to make that much of a difference because ground attacks might not be a thing on this team. But just the ability to avoid any ground attack they might use is pretty nice. The final Pokemon, I think I'm going to go just for type effectiveness. I'm going to bring Irwin the Krookodile as choice number 4 for this battle. So let's see what my opponent decides to lead off with in the active spot. First things first, I do want to rotate into Fluffy, get the Reflect up, try to get our defensive wall prepared. As in come the Mewtwo, Kyogre, and Rayquaza. Fortunately, if the Kyogre did have the blue orb, it's not going to be able to Primal Revert, because that only takes effect if they're in the active spot when the battle begins. As I say, first order of business is to go ahead into our defensive Clefable and get the Reflect up. Just in case they have physical attacks. Alright. See what the opponent decides to go for. They're going to probably, you know, most definitely outspeed. It's a Mega Mewtwo Y. Okay, so more specially offensive. And let's see what they go for. Shadow Ball. Alright, that's going to hurt. Not terribly bad, though. And the physical defense is up. Now, I'm hoping Snapper can handle a hit from this Mega Mewtwo Y, because I want to rotate into him and get a speed control on the opponent. Rock Tomb is the best way to do that. It's going to be neutral to the Mewtwo, neutral to the Kyogre, super effective to the Rayquaza, unless it Primal, not Primal, it doesn't Primal Revert, it Mega Evolves. And Aura Sphere, well, our Assault Vest should handle this, it's not a stab attack. Although that was pretty painful for a non-critical hit. So the Mega Mewtwo Y is slowed down. I do not believe Snapper will outspeed after a single speed drop. So if they're going to go Aura Sphere and they also had Shadow Ball, well, if they go Shadow Ball against Witwicky, that's going to hurt. Probably our best bet is to go back into Fluffy. I'm going to Thunder Wave this, actually. And if they rotate, we can Thunder Wave anything on the opposing side. Alright, Secret Power, what's this going to go for? Alright, good, Thunder Wave, you are paralyzed. Now we have a free turn to go for the Moonlight. Which is definitely the way to go. Let's get our Clefable healed back up. do we see a rotation on the opposing side. We do into Kyogre. Origin Pulse, we avoid that, nice. Alright, let's heal up quite nicely here. So how do I deal with the Origin Pulse? I can Thunder Wave this as well. And hopefully we don't rotate back into the Mewtwo. Because my Pokemon are not going to be faster than probably anything on the opposing side. These are all pretty slow Pokemon. Snapper is not bad. We dodge another Origin Pulse, nice. The luck is pulling through for this battle. Now, would they rotate into the Rayquaza? Probably not, because we are Fairy-type, and their Dragon attacks are not going to do anything. We did just lose the Reflect, so first order of business, get that back up. Excuse me, it's a clear my throat. Oh, they actually rotate into Rayquaza. So this is a Flying-type attack, Dragon Ascent. Our physical defense did just drop, but fortunately, so did theirs, thanks to the downside of Dragon Ascent. Let's go ahead and get a nice physical Reflect back up. I might want to burn this. Would they stay in with this, or would they rotate? I think our best bet, now that we have our physical defense up, we're going to Moonlight, just to heal back up. And it goes for Fly, okay. We did have a free turn to go for the healing. And what this means is, I do have a turn right now to go for Thunder Wave and paralyze this as well. So let's just do that. Gonna outspeed everything on the opposing side. Alright, minimal damage thanks to that Reflect. And now, you're also paralyzed, Rayquaza. Now, we didn't see it Mega Evolve, however. Wonder if they do not have the ability. They must if it has Dragon Ascent. What am I thinking? So let's go right ahead and I think the most damage we can get off would be Shadow Ball from Witwicky. So we're gonna do that. We do outspeed now thanks to that Thunder Wave Paralysis. Nice damage. And the Dragon Pulse is going to pop the Air Balloon. Uh-oh. We have some good special defense on this Pokemon. We handled that nicely. They might want to rotate into the Kyogre now, thinking that if they rotate into... Well, if they keep the Rayquaza active, Shadow Ball will drop it. If they rotate into Mewtwo, it's going to be super effective. So the Kyogre is going to be a problem. I'm thinking probably the best idea is to go with a Waterfall from Snapper and try to flinch it. Of course, it's going to be resisted. No, they stay active with the Dragon-type. Okay, so we're not going to get... It's also resisted by Dragon-type, so not a lot of damage coming off. But we might flinch it, and or if we're just fully paralyzed. So we just lost our Reflect again. I think now the best thing, I'm just going to go back into our Chandelure and go for that Shadow Ball once again. Do they rotate this time? They do not. We're going to drop the Rayquaza with a nice, powerful Shadow Ball. With a critical Shadow Ball. We could have used that the previous turn, but whatever. We got the KO. That's all that really matters. In comes the final Pokemon is going to be Lugia. So this is also a Psychic type. It's going to be weak to the Shadow Ball. Now, what is the play that they're going to make? I have a feeling they might want to go ahead and rotate into their Kyogre. So we're going to go into Fluffy and Moonlight to heal up. No, they just go with an Aeroblast. This is a high chance for critical hit. Fortunately, Lugia is not very specially offensive, despite being a legendary. It's more on the defensive side. Do I want to Thunder Wave this as well? That's probably the best option. But I have a feeling they're going to rotate. It's just a hunch. But I want to slow this thing down. I'm going to try Thunder Wave. They stay active. Punishment? Really? We resist that. They might have been expecting the Chandelure, however. So now that we have everything on the opposing side paralyzed, I can go ahead and go for the Shadow Ball from Witwicky. Even if the Kyogre comes up, it's going to weaken it to the point that the rest of the team should be able to whittle it down. And as far as type effectiveness, we do have Irwin waiting in the sidelines. He can go ahead and use Crunch on these two Psychic types. So we do see Mewtwo come in. Let's see how much damage this gets off. Shadow Ball away. So it does survive it. It goes for a Psychic, which is going to drop the Chandelure, of course. But that Mewtwo is not looking very healthy right now. We can get a good, nice KO with our Krookodile. And that might be what we do, because we can get the Moxie boost. They're not clearly going to keep their Psychic type up, though. So we're going to play a little bit of a risk. We're going to go with the Rock Slide. In case Lugia comes in, we can get super effective damage. Or if the Kyogre comes in, we can possibly flinch it. Or we could just knock out the Mewtwo Y. So let's get a nice Moxie boost for our Krookodile here. Now, gotta figure out what they're going to go for here. We can crunch the Lugia for some good damage. Might not knock it out immediately. Do they get multi-scale? I want to say that they do, as like a hidden ability, but I'm not sure exactly. I want to get some damage off on this first and foremost. Let's go ahead and Dazzling Gleam with our Clefable. Let's do this, Fluffy. Just in case they do have that multi-scale. Which it doesn't look like they do, because that was a decent amount of damage. So I'm thinking a Crunch might get it, but I'm going to first and foremost go ahead and rotate into Snapper. We're going to get off as much damage as we can with Waterfall. Let's see if we can actually pick up a flinch with this also. That was decent power, and we dodged the Hydro Pump. So now we're going to go ahead and it's a slight risk if that Kyogre comes up, but I'm going to go for the Crunch from Irwin. Which, if the Lugia stays active, we should get the KO. With that nice Moxie boost. Alright, another Moxie boost coming in now. So we're at plus 2 attack with our Krookodile. At this point, I wonder if an Earthquake will drop this Kyogre. Even if it doesn't, it's going to set it up nicely for a KO from either Snapper or Fluffy. So let's just go with Earthquake. I want to see how much damage we can get off with a plus 2 Earthquake. With the Muscle Band as well. Down goes Kyogre, and we pick up a win for Snapper the Totodile in our final rotation battles. Good game to my opponent. Our final opponent for the final week of rotation battles from Gunma, Japan has been located, and they've got a team that Burrow does not look like... Well, Burrow might not be too bad against some of these things. And since we did just get a win with Snapper, we do got to bring Burrow in for a chance to win. So we're going to lead with him. There we go. Enter. And who else to bring in? So Rock-type could be a problem from the Diancie. And not really much else. So best way to deal with Diancie, I'm thinking... Don't know. Rock would be good against our Chandelure, and Fairy would be good against our Krookodile. We could Earthquake it, however. Now, I didn't actually mention what's on the opposing side. We have Kyogre, Cresselia, White Kyurem, Arceus, the Diancie, of course, and Darkrai. So, I think defensively, I'm going to bring in Fluffy in case the Darkrai does make an appearance. And they go for the Dark Void, which is more than likely. I can go ahead and wake up with the Lumberry and Thunder Wave that thing immediately. Therefore, ensuring we're going to outspeed. So we do have defensive Pokemon. I wonder if I should go defensive on the other hand and go with our Musharna Sailor. Couldn't get any super effective damage off with Psychic, but we could yawn things to sleep. No, I'm going to go ahead and bring Irwin. We can get some super effective damage off on a good number of the opposing Pokemon. And the final Pokemon, either Witwicky. Maybe Witwicky. I can burn some things. Yeah, I think that's probably the best option. Now, of course, when he comes in out of the Pokeball as fourth choice, they're going to see that he has an Air Balloon. But I don't imagine there's going to be too many ground attacks coming our way, so the evasion of ground attacks is not really going to play that much of a difference for this final battle. So, let's see if they lead off with the Darkrai. Well, it is there. So, since we see everything on the opposing side can be Thunder Waved, I'm going to go right ahead and rotate into Fluffy. I'm expecting Darkrai might come up, so we will wake up with the Lumberry and we'll paralyze it with Thunder Wave. Look at that. Go ahead and Dark Void away. We actually dodge it. That works out pretty good too. So now I'm going to go ahead and rotate into Burrow and go for the Substitute. It's very nice we still have that Lumberry in play as well. Okay, let's Substitute away. Now, possibly the Arceus might still be faster. I don't think so, though. But we're about to find out. So the Substitute is active. You can break it if you want, but we're still going to get our nice speed boost. There is the Judgment Attack. Alright, so you can break that sub, go right ahead. We didn't get to see what type that was, though. It is neutral to our Buck Flying type. What color are you? You look like you might be Psychic. I'm going to make a risky play. I'm going to go rotate into our Krookodile. I'm going to try the Crunch Attack. I'm testing this out. Earth Power. Well, we could have stayed up with our Ninjask. Now let's find out, super effective or not? Nope, it's actually resisted. It's a fairy type. Okay, so let's go right on into our Clefable. I can just Thunder Wave again, probably. Might as well. Even if the Darkrai comes up and goes for Dark Void, we still have that Lumberry. Earth Power. We got the special defense to take this. And that wasn't even a critical hit. Okay. So let's Thunder Wave you, Arceus. I wonder, are they going to keep going for Earth Power? This might give me a chance to get the Substitute back up with our Ninjask. So let's go right ahead and give that a shot. There we go. So they stay active with the Arceus. Substitute is up in play, and they're fully paralyzed. Excellent. So we can go ahead and get super effective damage off with the Bug Bite on two of these Pokemon. But given the fact that we do have a Fairy-type Arceus in the active spot, I'm just going to go with the Aerial Ace. No, I'm going to go Struggle Bug. Weaken the special attack of the opposing Pokemon. Looks like they might be rotating at this point into the Cresselia. Let's lower that special attack. Now, Cresselia, from what I know, is very defensive, not so much offensive. But any lowered offensive stat on the opposing side is definitely a good thing to go for. They're going to Future Sight us. Does Future Sight hit Dark types? I don't know. I think we have a couple turns before we got to worry about that, though. So we did the Struggle Bug. I think we can go for the Bug Bite. They might have a Citrus Berry on this thing. Let's find out for sure. I didn't know, pay attention if they had health items at the team selection screen. That's some nice damage there. Critical hit. They're going to Aurora Beam, which will break the Substitute, I'm sure. Unless, no, wait, we did Struggle Bug. Yeah, down it goes. Alright, that is fine. Now, nice, another speed boost for our Ninjask. We're going to rotate out into our Dark type in case the Future Sight hits us now. Let's go right ahead and go for that Crunch Attack. Or, no, I was going to say Earthquake would be neutral to everything, but of course Cresselia has Levitate, so let's just go for the nice stab Crunch. See what happens here. They rotate into their Dark type, which is unfortunate. They might Dark Void us at this point. And it's a critical crunch. They're fully paralyzed. And the Future Sight doesn't affect our Dark type Krookodile. So let's go into Fluffy and fire off a Dazzling Gleam. Because again, as I say, we still have that Lumberry. Gets a nice, super effective stab fairy damage off. Look at that! Alright, down goes Darkrai. I was thinking I could have brought in Chandelure, Witwicky, and gone for the Safeguard, but we don't even need to worry about that right now. We have a white Curum with the Turbo Blaze. So Turbo Blaze means its attacks are not going to be affected by the abilities of the target, much like the abilities of, or not the abilities, the attacks of the new legendaries from Sun and Moon. So, we do have super effective damage with Dazzling Gleam. I might want to just Thunder Wave at this point, though. Let's go and Thunder Wave. Let's hope they don't rotate into their already paralyzed, which they didn't. Alright, so they go for a nice healing Moonlight. That is alright, we are going to paralyze you, slow you down nicely. And there we go, so as soon as we can take care of this Cresselia, we can go for the Earthquakes. Would they stay in the active spot with us right now, though? I don't know. I'm going to rotate into our Ninjask and go for another Substitute. And they stay active. All right, so if we can survive a hit here, which we will not do because we already saw that it did enough damage to break the sub before. All right, now let me do some math in my head here. So we have 32 HP. We've already used up. How much HP? I gotta see if I have enough HP left for a substitute. So we've got total is 122, so that is 90. Yeah, it's only using 30 HP per substitute. So I'm gonna substitute once more. We're gonna activate the Lychee Berry. I don't like being that low on the HP, but it kinda has to happen for this strategy. Alright, and they're gonna Future Sight. So we do have a free turn to go for a boosted attack. And the best option, I'm going to try Bug Bite. Hopefully that Fairy-type Arceus doesn't come up. Looks like they might be rotating, though. Yep, there it is. So we're going to at least get some attack-boosted damage off of the Bug Bite, although it is resisted. Not bad damage, though, actually. And Judgment is breaking our Substitute, of course. Now, question is, does the opponent have anything for speed priority on their side? I do not believe they do. Not in these Pokemon. Wait, I think Arceus can get extreme speed. So that is fairy type. I'm gonna go ahead and Earthquake. Let's just do that. And hope the Cresselia doesn't come up. Alright, what do they go for? Gonna stay active with the Arceus. I don't know if it's gonna get the KO. It does, actually. Down goes the god of the Pokemon world. And the Moxie Boost is right there. And Future Sight, once again, does not affect our Dark type. So Future Sight is not the best move to go for in these rotation battles, obviously, if your opponent has a Dark type. Now, the best attack to go with, I'm gonna say, probably is Crunch at this point. I don't think they're gonna rotate into the Cure Room just yet. And they don't, so we can get some super effective stab, attack boosted, muscle band boosted damage. All that being said, Cresselia falls to our Krookodile. We have an Ice and Dragon type remaining, but it has not yet been slowed down. I think probably our best idea, I'm gonna go ahead and rotate into Fluffy and Thunder Wave this. Let's see what they go for. Draco Meteor does not affect our fairy type. We're going to paralyze it nicely. Now he's going to go for the Rock Slide from our Krookodile. Actually, no, I'm going to play this out a little differently. I'm going to Dazzling Gleam first. Get some nice damage off on this. And here's what we're going to do. Now, we might lose our Clefable, which is totally fine, because I'm trying to give... Wait, we don't lose Fluffy. Well, here's what I want to do. I want to let Burrow have a chance to get the final KO. We're going to rotate into him and Bug Bite, see if he drops this Legendary. Come on, give it your all, buddy. Not quite. Iron Head brings him down. Oh, if we weakened it just a little bit more first, that would have been awesome. But unfortunately, he falls. But he did get a lot of good damage off on the opposing Pokemon. In comes our Chandelure with the Air Balloon, of course, and the Contest Ribbon. So let's let our Powerhouse get the final hit. Let's just Earthquake away with our Krookodile. Witwicky didn't look impressed with that, the choice of switching him out. But regardless, Witwicky... You did your part, you were moral support, you didn't actually attack, but regardless, we pick up a win, second win for this week, for the final week. Burrow is on a winning team, good game to my opponent. And so that's going to bring our rotation battles to a wrap once and for all with two wins, one for Snapper and one for Burrow, rounding out everybody except for poor little Cliff the Clefairy who didn't get a win. So that's unfortunate, but it's only one Pokemon that didn't win in the entire series, so I'm kind of okay with that. Cliff will give you a chance later on to get some sort of a victory in a different kind of format. So that being said, my initial thought was I'm going to go with triple battles for the next Omega Ruby Wi-Fi battles, but you're going to see next week I've got a different idea in mind. We're going to temporarily replace the Wi-Fi battles with something else. I'm not going to spoil what it is just yet, but you're going to see it's kind of connected to something else going on the channel, and I'm just going to leave it at that. It's going to be a little bit of a surprise for you all for next week. So with all that being said, I want to say thank you for checking out the final week of the rotation battles in Omega Ruby in the free battle in Battle Spot. As we know, or as we learned along the way, not the most competitive battles a lot of times because people can bring anything they want, but the fact that my team of non-legendaries, excluding Zapdos and Articuno, are up against a team of almost all legendaries usually every week, and the fact that we had so many good victories and good battles, you know, during the entire series, that really says a lot. My Pokemon do have the chance to stand up to these legendary, super high stat Pokemon, and that makes me really proud of my guys. So, if you have any comments you want to leave about these battles or the entire series as a whole, feel free to leave them down in the comments below. I look forward to hearing your feedback and some interaction. And if you have any suggestions for improved movesets for my Pokemon for future battles, leave those as well. I look forward to hearing some suggestions. And anyone that wants to use Pokemon that I use today, your suggestions could help them decide on some movesets for their own battles that they get into. So, with all that, I want to say thank you to everybody that stuck with me for the rotation battles and all the Wi-Fi battles along the way. As I've said, you know, at different parts of these series, I'm learning along the way to sort of get better at these battles, trying to predict the opponent, and it really came in handy this week, my experience in the Johto Classic, thinking defensively initially, getting some defensive screens up like the Reflect, and just going from that, not thinking all-out attack initially. So I've seen a different style of play come into my own interactions with the opponents and stuff, so definitely I'm more of a defensive trainer for now. Plus, the speed control came in as a sort of afterthought of the Kanto Classic also. So I want to say thank you once again for checking out the rotation battles. I hope you enjoy them as much as I did, and with all that being said, I'll catch you next time.